Hello friends, welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. In today's episode, let us talk about the pure consciousness or the state of witnessing and the memory or consciousness. So there is a huge difference between the state of witnessing and consciousness. Consciousness means the experience in the form of memory or the live experience, because ultimately all the experience get into the form of memory when we are disposed of our body or when we die. So I have taken this subject only because nowadays many people are confused between the true state of witnessing. What is the true state of witnessing? And what is a normal consciousness? Or consciousness which is composed of or which is made up of our experiences, our daily experiences. So what is the difference between these two? I am trying to clarify between these two states. You see, in pure witnessing, there is no system of memory. There is no memory, there is no experience. It is, you can say, pure chaitanya, pure chetan, or pure consciousness. Pure consciousness means a consciousness, a state of witnessing which is devoid of any experience. It means what? If something is devoid of experience, it means it is devoid of time and space. So true witnessing does not know anything about any time or any space. Time being our experience, time being our memory. Because ultimately, if we look at the nature of experience, it is the nature of time. If we look at the nature of memory, it is the nature of time or space. Because until there is a distance of time or distance of space, means there is a sense of a space and time, memory cannot be formed. So, memory is time, or time is memory. We can conclude like this. So, this is the normal consciousness of human being or any other conscious agent. So, this is not a true witnessing. Many people think that they are being witness to whatever they are experiencing. But that witnessing, in most of the cases, is the false witnessing, because they still look at all his or her experiences from the memory point of view, because they think they are witnessing, but actually they witness from his or her intellect. And intellect is nothing but the the compilation of all the experiences of one's life. So that is the intellect based witnessing. That is false witnessing. In true witnessing, there is no sense of any experience. There is no sense of me as the center. Now, that witness can see the whole system of this existence, the whole system. Before this witnessing state, everything is crystal clear. Now, let me tell you what are the systems which this witnessing, this pure witnessing sees, this pure drishta sees. The pure drishta sees the one entity. Nowadays, religious people, they talk about oneness. Okay, so that one being, okay, it is witnessed by that pure witnesser, who is devoid of memory. Only he can see, right, the whole system of existence. Okay, so firstly he sees the one entity, and it also witnesses that this one entity, which is full of primordial matter, being around 97%, and 3% being the space, and it can see, it can witness the one entity being active in that 3% space. So that is one being. Now, when this being desires to do something, so this sense of doing in that one being, it causes it to bifurcate in two systems. The system of, you can say, the energy of consciousness, and the system of Prakriti, these two systems. And consequently, because of this bifurcation, in this unit, there are so many or multiple jivatmas, which is the representative of the one, because it is a part of Prakriti. So it witnesses that one entity, it gets bifurcated in two systems, the energy of consciousness and the whole Prakriti. And in the Prakriti, okay, there are multiple jivatmas which represents the one, because this Prakriti, okay, it is the part of one. That is why that one is reflected in this Prakriti in the multiple forms of jivatmas. So we are all jivatmas. All the plants, all the animals, all the galaxies, everything is nothing but jivatmas. So the whole Prakriti has multiple units of jivatmas. So all these systems are witnessed by the true witness. And in the Prakriti, jivatma starts working from the inspiration of the energy of consciousness. Okay, so firstly, the one gets bifurcated in two units, energy of consciousness and Prakriti. This energy of consciousness causes all the jivatmas to work, or it makes them to work. It basically pushes them to do something or other. And in this way, the jivatmas starts getting all kinds of experience. Now, what happens when any jivatma dies? Dies means it dispose of its physical body. Okay, then whatever he or she has experienced in his or her lifetime, the whole experience becomes, you can say, the capsule of memory. Okay, memory in the beach form, right, in the seed form. And that memory in the seed form is the part of Mool or Prakriti, okay, the system which the witnesses. That memory belongs to that not with the only Jivatma. Jivatma is related to that memory, but memory is the part of the whole Prakriti, or you can say the whole system, not only Prakriti, the whole system, the Mool. So in this way, we can understand the difference between the pure witness, the pure Drashta, and the false Drashta, false witness, okay, which is basically the experience, the memory, or you can say the intellect of the Jivatma. So I just wanted to make it clear, okay, the difference between the pure witnessing state of mind, okay, and the memory, right, memory in the seed form. So there is a huge difference between these two, right? Memory is the part of this system, okay, Prakriti and Paramatma, but witness is not related to any one of them. It is alone, it is without any system, without any structure, without any experience, nothing at all. It does not know anything. There is no impact of any time, any space on that witnessing state of being. So hopefully you must have understood the difference between these two states, the false witnessing and the true witnessing state. So hopefully in the next episode, we will come up with the new topic, okay, which will be very, very interesting.